Googly Goo did not accompany them, as he was obliged to go home to get the money and jewels he had promised to pay old Blinky. So the other two climbed several flights of stairs and went through many passages until they came to the room occupied by Cap'n Bill. The sailor man, finding his bed soft and inviting, and being tired with the adventures he had experienced, had decided to take a nap. When the Wicked Witch and the King softly opened his door and entered, Cap'n Bill was snoring with such vigor that he did not hear them at all. Blinky approached the bed, and with her one eye anxiously stared at the sleeping stranger.
"Ah," she said in a soft whisper, "I believe you are right, King Krewl. The man looks to me like a very powerful wizard, but by luck I have caught him asleep, so I shall transform him before he wakes up, giving him such a form that he will be unable to oppose me."
"Careful," cautioned the King, also speaking low. "If he discovers what you are doing, he may destroy you, and that would annoy me because I need you to attend to Gloria."
But the Wicked Witch realized as well as he did that she must be careful. She carried over her arm a black bag, from which she drew several packets carefully wrapped in paper. Three of these she selected, replacing the others in the bag. Two of the packets she mixed together, and then she cautiously opened the third.
"Better stand back, Your Majesty," she advised, "for if this powder falls on you, you might be transformed yourself."
The King hastily retreated to the end of the room. As Blinky mixed the third powder with the others, she waved her hands over it, mumbled a few words, and then backed away as quickly as she could.